Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Future Friday. Today we're gonna take a look at electric airplanes. So let's dive right into it. Why we are even talking about it? One very simple reason. Fuel prices have been going up constantly. As you can see, from 1980s to right now, it's here. Now of course there have been some dip, but as you can see, the dip is still ever what we are used to. So suffice to say, overall the fuel is getting more and more and more and more expensive. And as of now, the jet engines have reached a point where the efficiency they can gain is barely 5 to 10%. We no longer have that, you know, giant innovation left, chemically speaking, that your engine would be like twice as powerful with half as fuel consumption. It's practically not possible. Like, best I have seen is a hoping 10-20% gain. So suffice to say, we really are running out of air. Second is pollution. Now you might say pollution is not that big of a deal. Here's the deal: many countries do employ a very strict regulation on jet plumes. Like jet engine just can't burn whatever they desire. There has a strict rule regulation, and not to mention, because they are such high altitude, they could even damage ozone layers. And nobody wants pollution, whether you like it or not, or there's alternate or not, nobody likes pollution. So suffice to say, there is a reason for it. So what's the problem? If there's this much drive, why we don't have it? Core component is energy density, how much joules you can pack per liter. Basically, to give you some idea how problematic the situation is jet fuel has generally 42.8 megajoule per kilogram. So if you have 1 kg of it, you have roughly that amount of energy. Lithium polymer batteries have 1.8 megajoules per kilogram. Suffice to say, you went from 42.8 to 1.8. So as you can see, and many people are like, okay, future battery will have more power. Not necessarily, given the fact that reason why petrol and hydrocarbons are so powerful is they are two-part component. They take their oxygen from the atmosphere. Now, if I had to show you guys the energy content of TNT, basically explosive, it's lower than petrol. The reason for that, TNT is self-contained and it releases all the energy in one go. And petrol does that very safely, very controlled way, where it takes oxygen from the atmosphere and then burns it. And that's why you only need like freaking few drops, not even full drops, like very few particulates of petrol to drive your car. So energy density wise, we are kind of stuck, and we can't make big planes like this. Basically, Airbus A380, as of now, the biggest plane, we just can't make this on batteries. And if we did that, this instead of having carrying capacity of roughly 800 people, will go to carrying capacity of 20 people. So suffice to say, we can't make big planes. So what do we got if we can't do them? There are still some hope on the horizon. In two specific categories, electric planes are taking the market by storm. One is ultralight, basically light aircrafts, generally done for recreational, short distance travel, farming purposes and all that. And then you have training aircraft, which is quite a big deal, given the fact that training aircrafts generally only do for 5 to 6 minutes, because it's quite taxing for a flight trainer to be constantly have to watch someone else like doing it. Generally, it's a good idea to take it in small chunks, so 5 minutes, 10 minutes. So suffice to say, we got some answers here. And these two companies, Airbus and Siemens, and there are other companies also dipping their toes into it to give us electric airplane. Benefit of these, while they are as of now more or less the same cost of normal planes, they are very quiet. Now, why does that matter? Imagine you opened your airfield in a place where, you know, it's kind of secluded place and people like the quiet. You can't go around and going brrrr. So suffice to say, and when this plane was unveiled, like, people thought like it has no, the motors were not running, because every reporter were like, I think it's running on motors. Like, they thought it's being pulled, but the moment the turbine, basically ducted fan, was faced towards them, then they realized the fans were actually running. It's quite remarkable how quiet these two things are. And we also have electric drones, which are getting way too much attention as of now. However, you have to realize, compared to planes, they have low capacity and range. So they cannot go, if you give the same battery, basically, if you take the same battery from this to that, you will have lower range and lower capacity. You will have higher noise, because all the you are not generating your lift by wings, you are generating your lift by blades, which are noisy by default, and it will be more expensive. But it does serve one very good function. They can make very great ambulances. Basically, ambulances have to clear the street, and people generally are more tolerant of noise and things like that for an ambulance. So I could see them being used as an ambulance. But other than that, their practical uses as an urban taxi, let's see how that plays out. But it can change everything. Now, this airport, as you can see, it's a big one. Like most of you know, like one big massive airport near you, basically 600 to 1000 kilometer distance, where you have generally one hub airport, basically all the airports come into, and then most of your state district will most likely will have this is a very small airport. Now this is the what's called last mile problem. Like you can travel from, let's say, China to India on this, but you can't go from here to your hometown because, well, there is no airport for that. Now this electric aircraft can solve that problem. Like this is quite easy, cheap to maintain. However, jet fuel is not without a license. Like you need to have license for that, you need to have maintenance for it, and it's not that easy. However, electricity on the other hand is just a grid connection. Basically you're getting a three-phase electricity connection, and you can have extra batteries. So instead of, like, you know, let's say there's a taxi service going from a big airport to it's not supposed to go very far, so 300 kilometer, let's say. So from this to small airports that, you know, regional, and they have only carrying capacity of 5 to 6 people, this can change a lot of things. Because of even an electric plane, while not as fast as 700 kilometers per hour or 800 kilometers per hour, still goes at like 250 to 150, which is still faster than most road transport and even rail transport. So this can change it. And you have to understand, many short distance flights are not economical and they are not served. Even if you have like two big airports on the other end, it's not very economical to run big giant planes on, like, you know, short routes. So this can also help in that. And cheap airline travel is training is very important for us. Like as more and more pilots are needed, you want to make sure the training cost goes down. So electric planes will play a very crucial role. So I expect in next 10 years we'll start to see first pilots to enter the service that have been trained on electric. Of course they will be trained on jet and all that, but to get them rolling with how dynamics work, how aerodynamics works and other things like that, it's a good idea to start small. So suffice to say, I think electric planes can change our world for the better. So this was my presentation. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, dislike, no problem with that, and leave a comment. Please subscribe and press the bell icon. I make video every day. And as always, thanks for watching.